to get to a Google advanced search, which is what you see on the screen here, I literally just Googled Google advanced search. As you can see, I like to do a lot of Google advanced searching. It remembered my terms, and it's usually up at the top, one of the first results. There's a lot of fields that you can leave blank, or you can tweak them, play around with them if you don't get good results the first search that you do. But maybe your instructor recommended a periodical, which is a magazine, newspaper, or journal that they want you to find an article from, and you're not sure how to limit to just that periodical. If you need help, though, like perhaps your instructor didn't recommend a specific title of a periodical, such as The New Yorker, we have FAQ that will tell you trustworthy periodicals that we recommend, or you can talk with a librarian to get more ideas on a source that might talk about your topic, a periodical source that might talk about your topic. But let's say they recommended The New Yorker, and so I Googled that to get the URL, and I'm going to paste that URL into the site or domain field. Also, you can, if your assignment were to allow it or suggest it, limit to .gov or .edu if your assignment allowed for those kinds of sources, and then you would only get government website results or educational institution results. But let's go back to The New Yorker, and let's say that my topic was about lakes and mythology. And as you can see, it created a search string for me, and all of the results that are coming up are now from The New Yorker. And you know, this one seems to be really close to my topic. Now, you may run into paywalls, and so it's good to use Google and like Google Scholar in conjunction with the library catalog. I have a good example here. Let's pretend that we have run into a paywall on this New York Times article. You can copy and paste the title into the discovery catalog, sometimes using quotations to make it search as a phrase, and it comes right up here. Sometimes it won't always come right up, so maybe you can do a search for instead the periodical it's coming from, but this is the article from the periodical. As you can see here, it's labeled as such, and we have under Access Online three databases which offer this article. So I'm just going to select one. It might prompt you to log in if you're not already logged in. And there's the article versus how it looked online. If we didn't have access to this article, but you were able to find a result for it in the catalog, it would prompt you to enter Library Loan It instead, which is a free service for students, faculty, and staff. So be sure to use Google and Google Scholar. We have a research guide on Google Scholar if you want to know more about that, but use those in conjunction with the catalog. I hope that this has been a helpful mini tutorial about how to use a Google advanced search. Check out our YouTube channel for more videos just like this one.